Sarah Ross is 94 years old and was an eyewitness to the birth of two modern nations of ancient peoples, China and Israel. Sarah grew up in Shanghai during World War II and has lived in Israel since 1948, but part of her heart still beats towards the East.
The best years of my life, of course, I spent in China. Because, first of all, people who accepted us in a very friendly way. Second thing, the quiet, because of a very cruel war about Holocaust, we knew nothing. We knew that, yes, it was a war, but of all those horrible things that happened there, incredible. Incredible.
She was born in Siberia in 1914 and moved with her family to China when she was just a year old. Her father was a horse breeder, and that skill helped the family to settle into their new home. Sarah grew up in Harbin and spent an event-filled decade in Shanghai. There, she met and married her husband, Ilya Rosenberg, born to Russian parents who also settled in China. During World War II, Shanghai took in 30,000 Jewish refugees who escaped the Nazi onslaught. That's more than Canada, Australia, New Zealand, South Africa, and India combined. Sarah and Eli, as she called Ilya, were active in Shanghai's vibrant Jewish community. But by 1948, the couple, like many Jews around the world drawn to their ancestral homeland after the Holocaust, felt the pull towards Zion and decided to resettle in the newborn state of Israel. To mark the opening of Expo Shanghai, Xinhua Israel correspondent Hao Fangjia met with Sarah at her home in Jerusalem. Sarah shares memories of the excitement and exotic life in Shanghai and proudly shows off a home filled with Chinese memorabilia.
At that time, Shanghai was wonderful. It was very difficult city, very difficult city. But at the same time, it was fantastic.
And despite the intervening decades, Sarah is still spry, alert, and blessed with a healthy sense of humor. She lovingly displays her mementos, among them dozens of small figurines of Chinese gods, each considered responsible for a different aspect of life, like health, wealth, and luck.
My gods here, they live very peacefully. And I think, darling, they help me because I'm still alive. I treat them all very well.
Yeah.
You see, even I give them horses to ride.
And horses may have been one way that Jews originally arrived in China. Scholars say Jews have been in the Middle Kingdom since at least the Han Dynasty from 206 BCE. They eventually settled in many areas of the country, including centers like Kaifeng. In the modern period, Jewish Sephardic, that is Middle Eastern, communities flourished in cities such as Shanghai and Hong Kong.
In Shanghai, you could meet people of all nations, of all ages.
But reports coming out of Nazi-occupied Europe about the horrors inflicted on her people were never far from Sarah's mind. The vivid memories haunt her even today.
6 million people, it is something. It is something. You know what? Even I would not do that to my panda, what they did for people. Even I would take pity, you know, to tear her, even a toy, and what they did with Jewish people.
Yeah, I know that.
Terrible. In China, we lived safely.
There were some 7 million people in Shanghai at that time, many of them foreigners. But Sarah says many immigrants managed to get by as the fighting abroad wore on. She found steady work as an agent for a photo agency, experience that would serve her well in the future.
When I came here, the first five presidents, I and my husband were working for them. I mean, took their photographs.
And after the two moved to Israel, Sarah and Eli developed their new careers. Both were soon hired by the Israeli government as official photographers at the presidential residence. There, they served under five governments.
It was very, very interesting people. Shazar, Ben Tzvi, Ben Gurion. They were the personalities. Of course, I wasn't a friend of theirs, but anyway, taking their photographs that make you, how to say, nearer to them. These are really people who are now like a legend.
One of her happier moments of the years with the presidents was the day she met the first Chinese ambassador to Israel, Lin Zhen, in 1992.
I saw in my list that Chinese first ambassador is coming to Israel. I was happy. And I told my husband, I'm going to take that photograph. When I came there, my heart was throbbing. I thought, really, going away from China, I never had even the slightest imagination to photograph the president, ambassador of the country where I lived all my life. And when the photos were ready, I gave it to our association, they gave it to our ambassador, and afterwards this ambassador came here as a visitor. And I took chance to take photo with him in a private way. And I presented him the photo, and on the other side I wrote down that I'm happy. I even didn't dream to take, after 30 years, photograph of the ambassador of the country where I happily lived all my life.
Sarah was excited when Hao told her about Expo Shanghai 2010. She has warm feelings for the city and its people, and recalls a story explaining why people are drawn to Shanghai.
There was one poor river, you know, and people, Russian people say, those who drank little water from Wampu City, they will be forever in love with Shanghai.
The Israeli pavilion and many events at Expo Shanghai take place on and along the Huangpu River that winds through the city. And back home in Jerusalem, Sarah enjoys spending time with her close friend Galina. Galina, like Sarah's husband Eli, was also born in China to Russian parents. Sarah and Galina share the same language and memories. They drink Russian and Chinese tea and reminisce.
Since I remember myself, among Chinese people. I could not imagine to live in the country where I should see only Europeans. Because since I was small, around me, I saw only Chinese people. My father was working with them, and we had very many good friends. No? So why should I not?
And on other days, Sarah and her aide Connie carefully make their way to the garden, where they pass the afternoon. Sarah loves talking with her family on her cell phone on these visits, and remembering with affection her years in Shanghai, a life in China long gone, but still very dear to her.